What's up, everyone? This is writer-director Edgar Ibarra with Filmspiration. I couldn't get the name of my own show right. And this week, we've got a very special guest, Mr. David Membrila. David, come on in a little bit more. I know you're not too crowded out there. There you go. So for everyone who's been following my work on YouTube, and now a little bit more so on Facebook, yeah, sorry, brain fart. Basically, I was approached about being the cinematographer and editor on a trailer production called SuperMEX a little bit back in December. But this project goes way further back beyond that. I'm going to do a little test here, David. But David, if you could just start off, who you are, what is SuperMEX, how did the project come to life? And I'm going to be doing a little test just to make sure that you can hear us.
Well, my name is Dave Membrila. I'm a local Tucsonan, born, bred, and raised here in the south side of Tucson. Grew up here as U of A, went to U of A, became a music teacher. I've been a music teacher for about 36 years. And
go Wildcats.
Go Wildcats. Been an actor, comedian. I've been a comedian for about 20 years. Used to travel during the summers and do as many one-nighters as I could during the week. And on top of that, I'm a hypnotherapist. I do hypnosis shows and a real estate agent. I don't know what I want to be when I grow up. So,
you know, David, why bother growing up, man? Just, you know, that's I was asked that one time. That's kind of my little reasoning. Let's see if anybody's tuned in yet. Sal Valdenegro, how you doing, man?
What's happening?
We hope everything's going well. Don't pay attention to this. This is a little bit of a delay here.
Okay.
Mr. Robert Linden, what's going on? Ladies and gentlemen, we've got Robert Linden, the one and only. He was the stunt coordinator on SuperMEX. Props out to this guy. He knows what he's doing when it comes to, like, martial arts, stunt stuff. Amazing dude on camera.
If you need a fight choreographer, bring in Robert. He kept our actors safe, number one. He auditioned for the part of SuperMEX, and he actually was too good.
You know Jesus Gaitan?
Jesus Gaitan, yes. Very outstanding bass player. He used to play with Lil Joe and La Familia.
So David, let's go back to SuperMEX. Talk to us about, you're venturing out into the world of independent film, and talk to us about SuperMEX. What is SuperMEX? How did it come about?
Well, it's been a scary ride. It started a couple of years ago. And I was looking, I'd written three films. This is the third film that I've written. It's the first film that I've actually done anything with. And the concept came from, when I was younger, I was studying judo, and the whole idea of, I may not be able to whoop anybody, but at least I could take a whooping. So I'd get thrown around by all the black belts. And I came up with the idea of, boy, if I charge them $5 a hit, I'd probably make a lot of money. And that concept always stayed with me. This particular character, that SuperMEX, is a victim of a home invasion that went awry, and he pays back the homeless colony who's taken him in by, again, going to these martial arts studios and getting his tail whooped and for donations. And with the donations, he buys groceries and blankets and stuff for the homeless colony and brings back to the homeless colony what he's learning at the martial arts studio. It was purposely, it's a martial arts film, but it's not a martial arts film. When we were looking to cast this, we weren't looking for a Jackie Chan or a Bruce Lee type of individual. We wanted an average Joe. And Robert Linden, when he came in, was wearing a t-shirt that was tight to his body. You could actually see the six-pack protruding from his abdomen. And so it was funny that he was actually too good of a character.
David, so we have Mary Veris, a professional contact of mine. Mary, hi, how you doing? So we'll eventually get to the film, but what I will tell you right now is we have a trailer to show you of the film. So stick with us for a little bit more. In a few more minutes, we'll put the trailer on. Mary, just hang with us, and you will see the SuperMEX trailer coming up here very shortly. So David, SuperMEX is originally, at this point, a feature-length script, right? But then what you did was you broke it down with local and amazing producer Fausto Olmos Renteria, into a trailer, correct?
Yes, and the whole idea was I wasn't having very much luck with the script. When I give the script to folks that I wanted to see if they were willing to invest in the project, they were always busy. And, of course, the script itself was about 85, 89 pages. And so I'd give it to them, check back with them a month, 2 months later. Well, you know, their response was always the same. Hey, I've been real busy. I haven't had a chance to get to it. Or I've gone through the first 7, 8 pages. I've got to go back and reread it. So I developed, there was a gentleman by the name of Bill Holmes, who was a very good friend, and my guru, actually, who was helping me put together a business plan. And he passed away unexpectedly last year, and so I was stuck as to what to do. But Bill kind of guided me in some way to developing, I just came up with a vision, a dream, and I have to credit him for somehow putting it in my brain, create a trailer instead of the movie. Create a trailer. It's going to be inexpensive. That way, when you meet with investors or anybody that really wants to see what the movie's about, you just hit play.
So the trailer kind of serves to inspire people and kind of help them visualize what your vision of the story is, right?
Yes, what the vision of the story is and what their donations or contributions or even their involvement could be. I mean, if somebody likes it enough that they want to invest money in it to get the production done, then I would have no problem with sitting down and negotiating what's in it for them.
Cool. David, so do you want to put the trailer on now?
Shoot, yeah, let's hit the trailer.
Okay, cool. So, Mary, if you're still with us, trailer.
Is a dangling...
Oh, yes. A dangling carrot.
Oh.
Mary, okay, then you know what? In saying that we have a trailer and we'll show you the trailer, it's probably serving its purpose if it is a dangling carrot. So tell you what, we will put the trailer back on, come back to us, chit-chat a little bit more, any questions, comments, concerns you may have, more so for David regarding the trailer. So without further ado, here is the SuperMEX trailer, and of course we'll play it again in time, okay?
Hope you enjoy it.
Obviously having some technical difficulties with the audio, which was that was my fear doing this Facebook live. Let me try it again.
We did have a big debut yesterday at Brother John's Beer, Bourbon, and Barbecue, and the video's there, actually. The audio's there.
No, but well, our audio's there, but not the audio for the trailer. That's the problem. Oh, yeah. So everyone, again, of course, technical issues. Give me a moment to work on this, but in the meantime, David, tell us about, you had your big debut yesterday. You debuted the trailer where and how did it go?
I had the debut at Brother John's Beer Bourbon Barbecue, the old Wildcat House, and it was outstanding. We had quite a crowd. I was pleased. A lot of them were friends and family, and a class of 1977 Warriors at Pueblo High School had a reunion this weekend. They've been on a 3-day binge, and somehow they crawled into Brother John's to support me, and I appreciate that. They were outstanding. The whole concept, it's kind of been a great ride. Scary, a little bumpy. But a couple of years ago, I was in a movie entitled The System is Broken with a gentleman by the name of Alberto Ojeda. And he was a local actor in town. We became really friends. And now,
hey, Mary, thank you. The trailer's amazing, even better with audio. So sorry, Dave. But I'm working on that. So let Dave fill you in on all of the background stuff while I work on this, okay? So I promise you I am working on it.
And Alberto's a film producer himself. He was in the middle of doing his own independent film. And I said, hey, when you get done with that, can you take a look at the script I wrote? And so he enjoyed the script, and he kept bugging me for about a year and a half. What are you going to do with this? Hey, you got to do something with this. What are you going to do? But, I mean, having been a novice in the business, I didn't know.
Hello, everybody, and thanks for checking out the trailer to the movie SuperMEX. Stick around for a brief message afterwards on how you, too, can become a part of our dream team to get our vision up on the big screen. Thanks.
An award-winning producer who I knew him only as a baseball coach. He was my son's baseball coach. I had no idea that he was involved in the business until a couple of years ago when I saw him in a film that he was the Lambrista.
Lambrista, the luchador film. David, I reloaded the clip.
Okay, let's get a shot. Let's
see. Hello, everybody, and thanks for checking out the trailer to the movie SuperMEX. Stick around for a brief message afterwards on how you, too, can become a part of our dream team to get our vision up on the big screen. Thanks and enjoy.
Mr. Yeyo.
What? I don't remember much.
El Yeyo, cabrón.
What are you talking about?
Mr. Yeyo.
You have the wrong house.
No te hagas pendejo.
You have the wrong house.
Play stupid with me, man.
I heard the sound of an AK.
Instant, everything changes. My family, my life, everything gone. Then homeless, but the people on the street took me in, and the community embraced me.
This is it right here.
Mr. Sanchez, open the door.
¿Qué quiere? ¿Qué quiere?
¿Dónde está Lito? Deja la puerta. Deja la puerta.
Lito's probation officer says he hasn't been seen in some time. Doesn't call in, check in, hasn't shown up for work.
I know. I haven't seen him either. Carajo.
It's more than that, señora. The courts cut him some slack because of the deal we made. If we gotta come back, he ain't gonna be.
Easy. You entiendo?
I hope you do.
I understand.
I hope you do. Here we go again.
No, he's gonna talk to you.
No, wait, we're done talking here.
I had to give back, somehow. But it wasn't enough, so I had to get tough by getting my ass kicked. To find my family's killers.
My favorite, piña colada.
And teach helpless Ready? Victims yeah. to defend themselves.
Elbows in.
Go. Good. Snap it back.
In. Left, right.
You got me there.
So I'm walking past this restaurant called Michas.
What's like that?
This guy just stops me.
This guy stinks, my God. Hey, your food's in the back, man. Go to the garbage dump.
Hey, I'm just trying to order my food.
You know what? Come on. I'm going to put a stop to this.
Hold on. Let's just see what happens.
Hey, I'm just
you know,
trying to get my food.
Come on.
Hey, dude, this stuff really works.
I made some friends along the way.
So, how'd you get all the way to Tucson?
Again, I don't remember much. I left El Paso.
Hey, SuperMEX. Heard about your vigilante escapades.
Yeah, she can't keep a secret.
Son of a bitch!
And got a little unwanted attention.
We finally discovered why the homeless have been able to defend themselves when accosted on the street. It seems that they've been getting trained by this man, Arturo Mendez. Yes, folks, there is a new sheriff in town, or at least a new marshal. Martial art, as he's being called by our station. Mr. Mendez, would you give us a few words for our station? We want to know how you've been training the homeless. We have a lot of questions. We want to know, do you know Jackie Chan? Who has trained you? What is the motivating force behind the work you're doing? Why are you running from me? We finally discovered why the homeless have been able to defend themselves on the street. It seems that they've been getting trained by this man, Arturo Mendez. Yes, folks, there is a new sheriff in town, or at least a new marshal. Martial art, as he's being called by our station. Mr.
Antonio, we got a problem.
Do you know Jackie Chan?
What is you working on another case outside of our jurisdiction, Santana? What gives?
Nothing really, most investigations taking place after hours.
So we working on other people's crimes with taxpayers' dimes? Just what we need to hit the newspapers. Stops now, got it?
Sir, we believe there's a connection in trafficking between El Paso and Tucson.
Wow! And you figure there's a connection between two border towns? What's next?
You're gonna tell me they're smuggling drugs into the country.
But sir, we...
Shh! You're here? It's a favor, and a favor only. Today. Stops. Today.
I promise you we're not going to waste taxpayers'
money. Stops today!
Our target subject is Omar Sosa. He's the brother of Antonio Sosa, both of El Paso. Both have done time for trafficking. We need to figure out what kind of motive Omar would have for double-crossing Antonio, assuming, of course, that he thought Antonio's house was yours. So we have to surveil like crazy.
But like I said, I had friends.
Monitor everything and everybody who comes in, who comes out. Take mental notes. Write down license plate numbers. Anything and everybody. Got it?
Which is a good thing, because I also had enemies.
I'm Eagle.
I'm out of violence, man. I abhor violence.
Look at your friend.
He messed up my wall. Tell me what I need to know.
And I pray they don't find me.
Where is this guy? Mendez.
Before I find them.
Welcome back, and we hope you enjoyed the trailer to the movie SuperMEX. But that's just what it is. Right now, it's just a trailer. The movie has not been produced yet. This is where we need your help. Please join us in donating to our crowdfunding efforts and helping us realize the vision of getting SuperMEX on the big screen and in theaters across the country. No donation is too big or too small. Please share it with your friends on Facebook. If you're a fan of independent films or you like what you saw, send them the YouTube link. Any donation will help. Thanks a lot and have a blessed day.
What's up, everyone? We're back. Audio's on. Yep. We're back. That was the trailer for SuperMEX, directed by Mr. David Membrila, producer Fausto Olmo Renteria, who also had one of the starring roles in the film. And that was the trailer, you guys. So, David, we've got Mary. Mary saw the trailer. I believe if Robert's still with us, he saw the trailer.
And
go ahead and talk to them.
Mary, I hope you remember me. I used to, we went to school together at U of A, College of Music. I was a sax player there. And I had asked Fausto if that was the same one or not. Gia's with us. And Gia's a local actress, and her daughter actually was the young lady who came out at the beginning of the film. Didn't want to do the part, and we were a little worried because we weren't sure how she was going to act. She understood what she'd have to do, and the whole thought of her dying in the film didn't appeal to her. But Gia had chatted with her, and she just did an outstanding job. I mean, when we filmed, that was probably the most intense filming in the entire trailer scene. It was, everybody was on edge, and Gia had tears in her eyes. It was scary. It was scary for all of us.
Robert, thank you for checking it out, man. There's your stunt work right there, brother. You directed all those guys and had a heavy hand in making it look as awesome as it looked with regards to, in many aspects, and obviously definitely with regards to the stunts. And Gia's daughter got hooked. Gia, are you saying your daughter got hooked on acting? Mary remembers you. You're a great musician. So,
I'm still teaching music too, Mary, son. That's my bread and butter.
Mario. Hey, Mario, are you still with us? If you're with us, give us a thumbs up or a little comment. He said he loved the trailer, brother.
Oh, right on. And, you know, you were right, Mario. It was a pretty long trailer. It wasn't intended to be that long, but what had happened was because we were using it as part of our funding project, we thought we didn't want to make it too long, but we wanted to give everybody enough gotten it to remember what the steak tastes like. And I've got to credit Edgar for being the magician who put the story together and the storyline. It's almost like a short. So it was pretty cool.
Now, David, so we, as you guys saw the trailer with after our technical issues, David actually came out on camera before and after explaining, you know, hey, here comes the trailer or not. That was an intro that was recorded before that I attached before or on the front end of the video. And then on the back end of the video, you have a message, David. David, what is that message? And it kind of takes us to the whole point of making the trailer, right?
We now have an Indiegogo campaign that's on Facebook. It's on my page, as well as we're going to link it up with YouTube as well, in hopes of just getting this out there and finding either folks that are willing to contribute or finding somebody who's willing to invest and say, hey, you know what, I'll fund your project. Let's get it done. The concept is kind of unique, and the acting was pretty well. We were pretty pleased with, and I can't thank these people enough. Most of them did it for free. I had to feed them, and they eat a lot. But
so ultimately, this is your, we say the film industry, but basically this is the community coming together for a vision that you had, this is kind of the end result, right? Like, you know, just a lot of people who had that passion to say, yeah, I'll be a part of this.
And what I did was I fed the script to a lot of different people. You saw some of the martial artists there. Johnny Linebarger out at Kosho Karate was world-renowned.
Mary, let's address Mary's. Hey, Mary, if you're still with us, I want to address your comment right here. So will you be doing the film in Spanish? It'll be a hit for our local Latino crowd.
Not necessarily in Spanish, but we're hoping that the Latinos and in the Hispanic community will come together and help us push this more than anything else. And again, we have the backing of Johnny Lomberger, I was saying, who's a world-renowned Kosho karate master, as well as Steve Owen out at the Tucson Judo Dojo. And
they were all amazing. They were
outstanding.
They were amazing with regards to what they brought to the table and put literally in front of the camera.
And Steve was the older gentleman who was in the Don Chava and the restaurant scene where he threw everybody around. He trained Don Fry. He's one of his coaches, and he loved the film. He loved being a part of it. And Steve is very reserved. He's not one who likes to get in front of the camera. And I think he had a good time. Chris Valdez, who is an ex-championship boxer here in town, who coaches a lot out at the Southwest Gym, he loved the film. Micha's Restaurant was very good about feeding the cast as often as possible. Don Chava helped us out as well with making a donation for the film. So we've been blessed by the community support. Now, hopefully, we can get into some of the community's pockets.
so definitely what you mean by that is people basically out there saying, you know what, this, seeing the trailer and seeing David's vision, saying, you know what, this is something that I can get behind. here in my community. You know, not just with your moral support and belief in the project, the creative belief in the project, but if you'd be kind enough to maybe open up your wallet to kind of see this through. And let's go to a few comments. Robert signed off. Robert, thank you for tuning in. We really appreciate it, man. We hope you enjoyed the trailer. Of course, check out the rebroadcast of this once it's up on Facebook, which will be in a little bit. Mary asks, what audiences are you targeting? David, what audiences are you targeting? David Gonzalez, sorry to cut you off, David. David Gonzalez, it's going to be a feature, and what you saw or can see again if you hang out will be, it's a trailer for the upcoming feature. So hopefully and God willing, it'll be a feature. Mary definitely believes we can do this. She loves independent films. Mario Slava loves independent films. Mario, this is, you can't get more independent than this is the grassroots movement of independent films. Not like the, oh, we only had $4.5 million to make this and we suffered. No, we're talking like actual grassroots. So thank you for loving and supporting independent film. Aida Grijalva, thank you for joining and jumping aboard. So let's go back to Mary's comment or question. Audiences, so who are you targeting with this, David?
We're trying to target all audiences. I'm trying not to make it just a pure Hispanic film like Mi Familia was or anything like that. I like to open it to everybody. It's a martial arts film without being a martial arts film. Again, we use the content and the character is supposed to be that of an average Joe who is helping out the homeless community that has embraced him. And that aspect came from my involvement in a group here in town called Exodus Community Services, where we help those in recovery, many of them were homeless, who transitioned back to independent living. And we work a lot with those who are homeless, and so there's a conscious message that we're trying to send out about the plight of the homeless. I mean, there's a lot of folks that live in danger every night. They don't necessarily fear for their lives because they're used to that scenario. But in essence, we're hoping that it brings to light some of the trials and tribulations they feel as well. They meet every day.
Now, Mary, your comment, this is the real thing. Are you talking about this being like the real thing, like the real a real independent film? And if that's my assumption, then yeah, you're right. Like, you can't get more indie than this. Grassroots, like many grassroots organizations doing amazing things here in Tucson, Arizona. The independent film community, very similar to a lot of other causes in that we create movies and whatnot. So if that's what you're referring to, then yeah.
One of the things that amazes me about the trailer and the way that Edgar put it together was that every time I look at it, I have to keep telling myself the production has not been created yet. Because it's hard to believe that we're able to do all these scenes, and it looks like it was, I mean, most people create the film and cut the trailer out of it. We just created the trailer.
So Mario Slava, Mario, so you're Gia's cousin. Oh, very cool. Yeah, your prima's definitely an actress, and boom, there you go. And if you didn't catch the trailer, we're going to play it again in just a few minutes. Susie Valenzuela, how you doing? You know Susie?
Susie's my ex-student. I could have been her father, actually. I dated her mom for a little bit. I'm not joking on that.
Susie, so I'm just joining. What will this film be called?
SuperMEX.
So, Susie, it's called SuperMEX, and what we have here is David Membrila's creation of the trailer to hopefully get us to make the feature. So, without further, Susie got a kick out of your comment. So. let's see if we can, Mary, Mario, Susie. All right. So, can we get a thumbs up if you guys want to see the trailer again right after David mentions what he would like to mention?
Here's what I'd love. I mean, here's how you can help. If you can get maybe snag it off my Facebook page and put it on your Facebook page and ask your friends to share it. I really need a lot of help, word of mouth. And I think that's going to be the best way to get it out there and just get, I mean, if nothing else, if folks are excited about doing it, just encourage me enough. I'll mortgage the house. I mean, kids can live outside for a while.
Mary says, just an idea. Get local youth involved in the production. High school age kids would love to be a part of a real production, and their parents would. That's true.
Very great idea.
That's true, because, I mean, you're an educator, David. You know that the kiddos and their parents got a lot of energy to, especially the kids. And so, Mary, that's a great idea. Already shared on Facebook.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mary. We appreciate that. And so with regards to how you can jump in with a donation of any size, no donations too big or too small, after this Facebook Live is over, in the description of this video, we will put the Indiegogo campaign link, and that'll take you on over to the campaign. If you can give $1, $5, $1 million, anything is appreciated, right, David?
Absolutely. Put us in your will.
Already shared with you. Mary, thank you for sharing it. Okay, so would you guys, let me see, Susie, Mario, I don't know if you, so you guys, we're going to play the trailer again, and hopefully there are no more audio issues like last time. So without further ado, Mary, count me in. Thank you very much, Mary. That's very, very kind of you. We really look forward to any support. Gia, LOL, David. Is Gia laughing at you, David?
Yeah.
Okay.
She was a kick to work with. I loved having her on the set. I got to explain what happened. I never told my wife that we were doing a bedroom scene. I just told her that I was having problems getting somebody to volunteer their house so we could shoot a scene in. I may need to use the bedroom, but she didn't know what that meant. So when she came home and found strangers inside our bed, it was almost like the Three Bears story. So
you see, shooting a scene in the bedroom, I mean, that kind of sounds, it sounds like what it sounds like, you know what I mean? But
that's going to be the next film.
But and you know what, ironically enough, that was like from an editing and a shooting standpoint, that was one of the scenes, which was the opening scene that I was very, very proud of. In cutting that, because of how gripping it is off the top. All right, everyone, without further ado, Gia says, OMG. Oh, my God. David, that's right. Oh, my God. All right, everyone, without further ado, let's do the SuperMEX trailer, and we will come back. Does she know about the coffee yet? Oh, man. On Facebook Live, Gia.
She's watching this, Gia.
Well, that didn't come from us. Okay, without further ado, everyone, here comes the trailer. David Membrila is SuperMEX, produced by Fausto Olmo Renteria. And take it away, Johnny.
Hello, everybody, and thanks for checking out the trailer to the movie SuperMEX. Stick around for a brief message afterwards on how you too can become a part of our dream team to get our vision up on the big screen. Thanks and enjoy.
The yeyo.
I don't remember much.
El yeyo, cabrón.
What are you talking about?
What's the yeyo?
You have the wrong house.
Don't you hagas pendejo.
You have the wrong house.
Play stupid with me, man.
I heard the sound of an AK.
And then, in an instant, everything changes. My family, my life, everything, gone. Then, homeless. But the people on the street took me in. And the community embraced me.
This is it right here.
Mr. Sanchez, open the door!
¿Qué quiere? ¿Qué quiere?
¿Dónde está Lito? Deja la puerta. Deja la puerta.
Lito's probation officer says he hasn't been seen in some time. Doesn't call in, check in, hasn't shown up for work.
I know. I haven't seen him either. Cabra.
It's more than that, señora. The courts cut him some slack because of the deal we made. If we gotta come back, he ain't gonna be.
Easy. You entiendo?
I hope you do.
I understand.
I hope you do. Here we go again.
No, he's gonna talk to you.
No, wait for that. We're done talking here.
had to give back somehow. But it wasn't enough, so I had to get tough by getting my ass kicked. To find my family's killers. And teach helpless victims to defend themselves.
Elbows in.
Go. Good. Snap it back.
In. Left, right. You got me there.
So I'm walking past this restaurant called Nietzsche's. Something like that. This guy just stops me. He goes, hey.
This guy stinks. My God. Hey, your food's in the back, man. Go to the garbage dump.
Hey, I'm just trying to order my food.
You know what? Come on. I'm gonna stop this.
Hold on.
Let's see what happens.
Hey, I'm just trying to get my food. Come on.
Hey, Duty, this stuff really works.
But I made some friends along the way.
So, how'd you get all the way to Tucson?
Again, I don't remember much. I left El Paso.
Hey, SuperMEX. Heard a bunch of vigilante escapades.
Yeah, she can't keep a secret.
Son of a bitch!
And got a little unwanted attention.
We finally discovered why the homeless have been able to defend themselves when accosted on the street. It seems that they've been getting trained by this man, Arturo Mendez. Yes, folks, there is a new sheriff in town, or at least a new marshal. Martial art, as he's being called by our station. Mr. Mendez, would you give us a few words for our station? We want to know how you've been training the homeless. We have a lot of questions. We want to know, do you know Jackie Chan? Who has trained you? What is the motivating force behind the work you're doing? Why are you running from me?
We finally discovered why the homeless have been able to defend themselves on the street. It seems that they've been getting trained by this man, Arturo Mendez. Yes, folks, there is a new sheriff in town, or at least a new marshal. Martial art, as he's being called by our station. Mr.
Antonio, we got a problem.
Do you know Jackie Chan?
What is you working on another case outside of our jurisdiction, Santana? What gives?
Nothing really. Most investigations taking place after hours.
So we working on other people's crimes with taxpayers' dimes? Just what we need to hit the newspapers. Stops now. Got it?
Sir, we believe there's a connection in trafficking between El Paso and Tucson.
Wow! And you figure there's a connection between two border towns? What's next?
You're gonna tell me they're smuggling drugs into the country.
But sir, we...
Shh! You're here? As a favor, and a favor only. Today. Stops. Today.
I promise you we're not gonna waste taxpayers'
money. Stops today.
Our target subject is Omar Sosa. He's the brother of Antonio Sosa, both of El Paso.
Stops.
Both have done time for traffic.
We
need to figure out what kind of motive Omar would have. Our target subject is Omar Sosa, that he thought Antonio's house was yours. So we have to surveil like crazy.
But like I said, I had friends.
Monitor everything and everybody who comes in, who comes out. Take mental notes. Write down license plate numbers. Anything and everybody. Got it?
Which is a good thing, because I also had enemies.
I'm Eagle. I'm a lot of violence, man. I abhor violence.
Look at your friend.
He messed up my wall. Tell me what I need to know.
And I pray they don't find me.
Where is this guy? Mendez.
Before I find them.
Welcome back, and we hope you enjoyed the trailer to the movie SuperMEX. But that's just what it is. Right now, it's just a trailer. The movie has not been produced yet. This is where we need your help. Please join us in donating to our crowdfunding efforts and helping us realize the vision of getting SuperMEX on the big screen and in theaters across the country. No donation is too big or too small. Please share it with your friends on Facebook. If you're a fan of independent films or you like what you saw, send them the YouTube link. Any donation will help. Thanks a lot and have a blessed day.
All right, Susie, can you hear us now? Thank you for letting us know. Just went on this whole
We're route. Seeing if you can read lips.
Exactly. It was really a test, Susie. Mario, okay, so you guys should be able to hear us now, although with a little delay. But you guys, Gia, thank you so much for sharing it. There you go, some thumbs up. Thank you. Gia, thank you for sharing it to my cousin Omar. Omar, if you're still there, give me a thumbs up or say hello or something, man. I want to see that we didn't lose you. And Omar, that's a little taste of Tucson filmmaking that goes on over here in Tucson with my buddy, writer-director, Dave Membrila. And that's his trailer to a short film. There's Susie. Yes. No audio, no audio, but we got audio back for sure because now we can see it up there. A little line moving. So yeah, Dave, you know, trailer
better
second time. Mario, so it sounds like it just gets better and better for you when you check it out over and over again.
Yeah, it's
David, talk to us about a little bit more about you know, ultimately what is your goal or your vision with just, you know, making the film? Because you know what? In that goal and in that vision, let me ask you another question more specific to this show called Filmspiration. Inspiration for everyone through the lens of a filmmaker, right? Get it?
I got that.
bad joke. But that's how my wife fell in love with me. Bad jokes. David, so filmmaking is not for everyone because it really makes you want to pull your eyeballs out of your sockets. Makes you want to pull your hair out of your head. What keeps you going, especially when, you know, when times got rough and when things did not always go according to plan, which is all the time in filmmaking?
My biggest support came from the filmmaking industry. Again, Edgar, Fausto, we had a situation where we had Edgar couldn't make one of the shootings, and so Alfonso. I can never pronounce his last name.
Alfonso Sagún Casals. Thank you for jumping in, brother.
Yes, he shot the whole day. And again, Alfonso is another... Edgar's a three-time Emmy Award-winning cinematographer and two-time. Okay, and Alfonso is as well. Alfonso is another two-time Emmy. And let me get to that story. What had happened was that once I got Fausto involved, and again, I didn't know Fausto other than being my son's baseball coach, and I found out that he also... is an award-winning producer that I happen to know. And so he basically volunteered to get involved in the project. He liked the film, and he took off with it. We had a cinematographer that we were going to fly in from L.A., and it was going to be a weekend shoot, and we were about ready to buy our plane tickets, and for whatever reason, she bailed on us. And so we were stuck. I didn't know what to do. And Fausto was actually pretty responsible for keeping me calm throughout this whole ordeal, because I'm pretty wild-tied being a band director, having a marching band of more than 100 kids and making sure they get on buses and get to where they're supposed to be. I mean, I'm always kind of just wound tight, and he kept me calm a lot of the time. And he told me, hey, this is just one of the things that happened in the filming industry. No biggie. We'll get through this. And we were looking for a cinematographer. In fact, we had interviewed one guy at a native New Yorker. And we find out really easy in this business how many people are really on the level or how many people are just full of duty. This one gentleman came in to interview and gave us his whole spiel about how he worked on this movie. It was a movie here in town. And without knowing that Rogelio Camarillo, who was the sound guy, also the lead character, he was the SuperMEX, I asked him a few questions because he was the sound guy in the movies that the gentleman was talking about. So the guy went to the bathroom, and we were waiting on him to come out, and he ended up sneaking out the back door. He couldn't handle the questions. So that was kind of funny. We didn't have anybody else to go to, and what was funny is that I had contacted Raul Aguirre, who's a really good friend of mine. Hey, do you know any cinematographers? And he gave me the name of Edgar. He says, Edgar Ibarra, Channel 4, you got to go out there. You got to catch him, man. He's good, man. You got to get him. And so I gave Edgar a call. And actually, before I called Edgar, I called Fausto. And I said, hey, I got this name of this guy named Edgar Ibarra. Oh, yeah, he's my compadre. I said, you guys are compadres? You didn't even say anything about
everyone knows each other in town.
And Fausto says, Edgar doesn't do anybody's films but his own. Because Edgar is a film producer and a cinematographer, does his own films himself as well, an indie developer. So I called Edgar, and I let him know over the phone, and I don't know what made him decide to get involved, but thank God he did. He's pretty much the magician behind the whole scope of the trailer. He took over a lot of directing duties and helped us with our acting, what he wanted to see, Bing Bang Boom. And helped us get the job done. So, I mean, everything's kind of falling into place. If there's anything that I can, any advice that I can give to anybody who's ever wanted to do this, is just do it. Just do it. Everything will fall in place one way or another. There are times that I'm thinking, what do we do here? What do we do there? We don't have this. And it just got done. So you can't go after your dreams without closing your eyes and just getting it done. So, I mean, if you've ever wanted to write a film, start by writing little short stories and go from there. Develop this, whatever the idea is, into a short. Or mine happened to be full-length features because, again, I'm a novice at this. If I'd have known better, I probably would have started out with a short. It would have made it a lot easier for me in my writing. But I wrote this in the summer months a couple of years ago. And I'm glad it's a feature, but now that it is a feature, I'm obligated to get it done and to finish it, especially for everybody that came on board. And when we had the viewing yesterday, we had a preview of the screen of the trailer at the Brother John's Beer, Bourbon, and Barbecue, which is the old Wildcat House. We had a packed house, and I was waiting for somebody really give me some negative reviews. Anybody something they didn't like, and everybody seemed to like it. In fact, they thought it was a comedy, and it wasn't intended to be a comedy. It was intended to be more of an action with the comedy in it. But as you can see through the trailer, we just had a lot of fun with it. So,
David, one moment. We've got let me see, Maria Eugenia, Tia Jenny, out in Las Vegas. How are you? Hope you're doing good.
Hi, Tia Jenny.
This is my buddy David Membrila, writer director, and hang out. We're gonna play his trailer for hopefully a soon to be feature film coming up. So hang, stay with us. Mario says I want to write a short. Mario, don't want to do it, brother. Just do it. Just do it, man. Even if you don't go out there and I don't know how versed you are in the three act structure. Just get online. Look. You know, how to write a screenplay. There's a ton of resources out there on the internet. Just go ahead and do it.
And if it's something you really want to do, invest in a finale program, a screenwriting program, something like that. And again, I just keep writing because this is my third film, but it's the first one that I ever looked at. I thought, you know what? This is believable. I think I can do something with this.
Karen Garcia Geisen joined. Karen is the wife of Julio, who played the home invasion.
Oh, yeah.
One of the two home invasion dudes.
I love your husband. I love him.
We all love it. It's hard to not love Julio, Karen. Karen, thank you for jumping aboard. Please share this, check it out, and stick with us. If you haven't seen the trailer, Karen, we're going to play it again in just a little bit. David says, Fausto sounds like a great creative spirit. He does great work. I'm a fan of both Fausto and Edgar. You guys are inspiring. David, thanks a lot, man. We appreciate that. You know, our time and resources, like yours, like anybody else, are limited. But if at the very least we can offer you that, we are more than happy to. If at the very least we can offer you inspiration and motivation to go out and do your thing, even against the odds, very little money, very little gear, just run out and do your thing, man. And we're happy to inspire you always. Cristina Aceves Palomares Marin, thank you so much for joining and checking out what we do here in Tucson. We're going to play the trailer in just a little bit. Mario, so many apps for the iPhone and screenwriting, also for storyboarding. That's very, very true. If you just go into like your store, what do they call it on?
The App Store?
Yeah, the App Store.
Or the Apple Store?
Just, you know, do a search for screenwriting or screenwriting tools. I actually have one on my other phone. The most generic thing, it was actually free. I don't know exactly what it's called. But there's a lot of free stuff out there, you guys.
You gotta read Susie's. Susie, you and I are already friends on Facebook. I have the Indiegogo page right on my feed. So if you just go through my feed, you'll find it. And I appreciate your support. Any contribution you can make, if you can share it, let people know, that's going to be the best idea, because I'm hoping that there's folks out there that want to see more independent films being made here in Tucson, or getting the folks from LA to come down and film. I mean, there was a time that Tucson was a booming in the filming industry for different movies. You know, we remember the old Tucson High being used.
Can't Buy Me Love.
And, of course, old Tucson Studios and a lot of different films being shot out here.
Hey,
let's bring it back.
Sorry to cut you off. Everyone, so I couldn't post it in the actual body or the text of this post, but scroll up. We forgot to mention this, David. Scroll up. You'll find the link so that you can support SuperMEX with a donation of any size at the Indiegogo page. So just scroll up right here. It's in the comments right above everyone's comments. So Susie, go ahead and find it right up there. Chris Farmer just joined. Chris, thank you so much for jumping aboard. We're talking about a local writer director, Dave Membrila's trailer called SuperMEX. It's like an action kung fu thing. Hang out and you'll be able to see the trailer in just a little bit more. David, what else you got? Do you guys have any questions that we can answer with regards to the trailer? Because we want this to be about you guys more than anything. I mean, that's why directors make movies for an audience, right? So we don't want to yap on and on and on. Like, we want to hear what you guys think, and if you guys have any questions about the filmmaking, in this case, SuperMEX, that goes on here in Tucson, which there's a lot of, by the way. But, you know, if you guys have any questions, throw them our way. We'll wait. Ready? Go.
But in the meantime, I mean, if any of you guys want to really get involved in some of the films that's going on right now, there's a ton of films that folks are auditioning for different indie, and they're always looking for, if nothing else, extras. We need a lot of extras on our film. I know that Sal Valdenegro, who's another film producer here in town, he's embarking right now on auditions for a film that he's created. So just continue checking in with Edgar and on this site, and he'll steer you to different auditions that are happening, or different contacts for folks that need extras at least, or that are looking for people to audition.
Very true, David. Very true. All right. You guys want to see the trailer one more time, David?
Yeah, let's do it one more time. We'll call it a night.
All right, cool. And thank you for everyone for showing up. David Gonzalez, what were David's two other films he wrote? What other films did you write, David?
The first,
Thank you for the question also, David, because we're happy to answer any questions. We're not here to yap on and on about just the things that we want to talk about. So thank you for the question.
Well, the first film I wrote was actually called No Remote Control. And it was supposed to be no with a big no sign, like you would say, no entering or no stopping, whatever it is here. And the whole concept was, and I have a copyright, so I guess I can say what the concept was. It was right back before the big major TVs came out. And the concept was, I have a nephew that was also in the comedy industry, who kind of inspired me. He loved working on computers. And he built this wall-to-wall television that he wanted to use to be able to observe, like Kid Peek, stars and planets and all that kind of stuff that he had created to also let me view the U of A ASU game. So, and because it was going to be wall-to-wall, I was going to have some buddies over, that kind of stuff. But he had the two different remotes, one for the stars and looking at the galaxies, and another one for the remote to the TV.
Frank Aguilar.
Yeah, Frank Aguilar. I was just kissing him this weekend. And so the concept was that we took the wrong remote, we got zapped into the TV, and first thing was we're watching a Nazi movie, a World War II movie, and we're zapped into the TV, and we become part of the film. And we don't know how to get out of the TV. My nephew sees it, and right when we're going to get shot with Nazis, he hits a remote and he throws us into another cowboy western where we're running from bandits and everything else on horses, and you know that we're going to get hung because they think we're with Billy the Kid and that whole bit. And he sees that. He doesn't know how to get us out of the TV. He keeps switching it, so it switches into various scenes. We're in a midget wrestling scene, this, that, and the other thing. And finally, he can't figure out how to get us out of the TV. He remembers the U of A ASU game is on, so he switches to that channel, and here we are catching a football in U of A football gear, and he comes up in front of the stadium, picks us up, and that's how he takes us home. So, I mean, that I wanted to produce that film, but money-wise, budget-wise, it was just too much money. I mean, I'm thinking I'd need horses, I'd need, we had guns, we had this, so I'd have to secure too many things. So I shelved it, but what killed me is that right after I wrote the movie, about a half a year later, they started coming out with all these wall-to-wall plasma TVs, and I thought, oh man, it's almost defeats my purpose.
It could have like preceded that, the whole era of like the Colossus.
Yeah, if I'd have written the story maybe a year earlier, but then the second film I wrote was a film called Tituba's Reign. Tituba was actually the first person that was ever accused of being a witch in Salem, Massachusetts. She was never hung, or she was never, she was tried, and she was actually acquitted, but they actually hung 16 other innocent girls that they had accused of witchcraft. And so Tituba's Reign was about her coming back to get even for all that. So it's kind of, and that was kind of cool. In fact, I pitched that, once I did the movie, I pitched it to Carlos Mencia, who, from what I understand from his wife, when I talked to her, liked the movie, but he was in the middle of moving his office, and he misplaced it, and they had asked me for another copy, but I just kind of thought, you know what, I'm going to hold on to it for a little while. So I shelved that, and I still have that, and this, of course, is the third one. This was the one that I thought, you know what, this I wrote it with budget in mind. I wrote it with the idea that, okay, I can't keep writing movies. I want to do something with it. So this one's the one that actually came together for me.
And that goes back to what you just said earlier, like you just got to do it, right?
Just got to do it. I mean, it's just, you just got to make it work, whatever it is. I mean, of course, there are some limitations, but I'm hoping that maybe if this one takes off and I make some contacts, and maybe I can pull out the other ones and maybe rewrite them or revise them, and hopefully, if my name is out there ready, I'll have somebody that will say, hey, we'll invest in you again.
Very cool. David, what do you say we...
Let's shoot it.
If everyone has not seen the trailer...
And again, I'm sorry. The best thing you can do to help us out is to share it on your Facebook page, and please invite all your other friends to share it. If nothing else, even if we don't make our goal in the Indiegogo, if we just create some excitement I just need to hear enough people saying, you know what, you can do this. Because again, this is my first time out.
Yeah, because I mean, you know, here at the very least, we're starting off by letting people know, like, there's, you know, for those of you who are not familiar with the independent film scene at all, or in your local towns or here in Tucson, there's a scene. There's stuff happening, and SuperMEX, written and directed by David, is one of those projects that is happening here in town, and we, if at the very least, want to let you know and put it on your radar that this is happening, and hopefully, with the link above in the comments, you can, you know, take maybe $1, $5, $10, whatever you can give, and just say, yeah, you know what, I believe in this project. Like, let's go ahead and do it. So, without further ado, everyone, let's go ahead and take a dip, a dip in the pool, a trip down to Trailer Land one more time. Okay, here we go.
And again, it's just an 8-minute trailer, so hang out.
Well, I hit the wrong one.
Hello, everybody, and thanks for checking out the trailer to the movie SuperMEX. Stick around for a brief message afterwards on how you, too, can become a part of our dream team to get our vision up on the big screen. Thanks and enjoy.
Mr. Yeyo.
I don't remember much.
El Yeyo, cabrón.
What are you talking about?
What's the Yeyo?
You have the wrong house.
Don't te hagas pendejo.
You have the wrong house. Play stupid with me, man.
I heard the sound of an AK.
No!
And then, in an instant, everything changes. My family, my life, everything. Gone. Then homeless. But the people on the street took me in. And the community embraced me.
This is it right here.
Mr. Sanchez, open the door!
¿Qué quiere? ¿Qué quiere?
¿Dónde está Lito? Deja la puerta.
Lito's probation officer says he hasn't been seen in some time. Doesn't call in, check in, hasn't shown up for work.
I know. I haven't seen him either. Carajo.
It's more than that, señora. The courts cut him some slack because of the deal we made. If we gotta come back, he ain't gonna be.
Easy. You understand?
I hope you do.
I understand.
I hope you do. Here we go again.
No, he's gonna talk to you.
No, why do that? We're done talking here.
I had to give back somehow. But it wasn't enough, so I had to get tough by getting my ass kicked. To find my family's killers.
Favorite piña colada.
And teach helpless Ready? Victims yeah. to defend themselves.
Elbows in.
Go. Good. Snap it back.
In. Left, right.
You got me there.
So I'm walking past this restaurant called Michas. Something like that. This guy just stops me.
This guy stinks. My God. Hey, your food's in the back, man. Go to the garbage dump.
I'm just trying to order my food.
You know what? Come on, put a stop to this.
Hold on. Let's see what happens.
Hey, I'm just
trying
to get my food.
Come on.
Hey, dude, this stuff really works.
But I made some friends along the way.
So, how'd you get all the way to Tucson?
Again, I don't remember much. I left El Paso.
Hey, SuperMEX. Heard a bunch of vigilante escapades.
Yeah, she can't keep a secret.
Son of a bitch!
And got a little unwanted attention.
We finally discovered why the homeless have been able to defend themselves when accosted on the street. It seems that they've been getting trained by this man, Arturo Mendez. Yes, folks, there is a new sheriff in town, or at least a new marshal. Martial art, as he's being called by our station. Mr. Mendez, would you give us a few words for our station? We want to know how you've been training the homeless. We have a lot of questions. We want to know, do you know Jackie Chan? Who has trained you? What is the motivating force behind the work you're doing? Why are you running from me? We finally discovered why the homeless have been able to defend themselves. It seems that they've been getting trained by this man, Arturo Mendez. Yes, folks, there is a new sheriff in town, or at least a new marshal. Martial art, as he's being called by our station, Mr.
Antonio, we got a problem.
Do you know Jackie Chan?
What is, you're working on another case outside of our jurisdiction, Santana? What gives?
Nothing really. Most investigations taking place after hours.
So we're working on other people's crimes with taxpayers' dimes? Just what we need to hit the newspapers. Stops now. Got it?
Sir, we believe there's a connection in trafficking between El Paso and Tucson.
Wow! And you figure there's a connection between two border towns? What's next?
You're gonna tell me they're smuggling drugs into the country.
But sir, we...
You're here as a favor, and a favor only. Today. Stops. Today.
I promise you we're not gonna waste taxpayers' money.
Stops today.
Our target subject is Omar Sosa. He's the brother of Antonio Sosa, both of El Paso. Both have done time for trafficking. We need to figure out what kind of motive Omar would have for double-crossing Antonio, assuming, of course, that he thought Antonio's house was yours. So we have to surveil like crazy.
But like I said, I had friends.
Monitor everything and everybody who comes in, who comes out. Take mental notes. Write down license plate numbers. Anything and everybody. Got it?
Which is a good thing, because I also had enemies.
I'm Eagle.
I'm out of violence, man. I abhor violence.
Look at your friend. He messed up my wall.
Tell me what I need to know.
And I pray they don't find me.
Where is this guy? Mendez.
Before I find them.
Welcome back, and we hope you enjoyed the trailer to the movie SuperMEX. But that's just what it is. Right now, it's just a trailer. The movie has not been produced yet. This is where we need your help. Please join us in donating to our crowdfunding efforts and helping us realize the vision of getting SuperMEX on the big screen and in theaters across the country. No donation is too big or too small. Please share it with your friends on Facebook. If you're a fan of independent films or you like what you saw, send them the YouTube link. Any donation will help. Thanks a lot and have a blessed day.
All right, everyone. David Membrila and Edgar Ibarra are back. That was the trailer for... my phone's dying. My phone is dying is not the title of the film. that was the trailer. SuperMEX.
I also got to give props to Richard Islas, who's a local musician here in town, who came up with the actual SuperMEX theme song.
And
I was surprised to... He was really excited about seeing the debut. I hope he's okay. He didn't make it out there, and I've been trying to get a hold of him. So I'm hoping Richard's out there. But thanks again, Richard Islas, for all the help you gave us. And, of course, Don Chava Restaurant, as well as Micha's Restaurant, for their engagement, Brother John's Beer, Bourbon, and Barbecue. We raised money for this trailer by hosting a comedy event. And I got to give... credit to the comedians that came in. They donated their time. Floyd Haas and Ben Creed, and of course everybody else that came out to the show. Guillermo Robles from Phoenix, who we've been friends for quite a while, And the three of the comedians and myself put on the show. None of the guys charged me because they that's just the support that they've given me. And we raised about $2,800, which pretty much paid for the trailer. So we had a lot of support.
David Gonzalez, if you're still with us, give us a little thumbs up, a little something. I saw your comment right there. Great editing. Thank you so much. This was a big task in that it required a lot of precision editing. Using only the basics. It was a one camera shoot, one computer. It was chopped on. I chopped it on Final Cut Pro, older version CS5. But still does the job nicely, as you saw. Thank you very much for your comment on the editing. And everyone, so the latest comment right there, which is the one I put right there, so SuperMEX Indiegogo campaign, the link is right there. Just go ahead and, like, if you say, damn, I want to get behind this production, because these guys, like, you know, they did this trailer, imagine what they could do if I helped them out. And it's not just about, you know, you giving money. It's about you having ownership in, and I mean this figuratively and artistically, in a piece of Tucson filmmaking that happens. That when you give a little piece of yourself, if it's a dollar, five, ten, twenty, whatever you can afford, whatever works for you, you can look at the final product and ultimately say, I helped with that. I helped make that come to life. And that's kind of one of the beautiful things that I've come to know whenever I've given to campaigns in the past is, a production is happening because somebody like you cared. And that's the bigger meaning, message, and definition behind if you decide to give, which we hope that you do.
Thank you very much again for your support and at least viewing the trailer as well as chiming in on this podcast. And hope to see you soon and help us get the word out. Thank you again for enjoying.
And everyone, to link up, if you guys want to jump into the Producciones Sequoia group page. And then also this podcast will also be on my YouTube page. If you just do YouTube search Edgar Ibarra with a Y, Y-B-A-R-R-A, Edgar like the dead drunk poet who married his cousin Edgar Allan Poe. If you guys just go there, you can find the podcast here on Facebook, and then of course on YouTube, and if we're linked up, all the links for Instagram as well as Twitter, this one right here, and YouTube, and my Producciones Sequoia group page is where you can find, at all those locations, you can find this podcast as well as the link to David's campaign. Again, we really hope that you'll give a little something, whatever you can give is always appreciated. And
if you want to friend me as well, you'll see the SuperMEX page. It's a page on my Facebook page.
Yeah, they can, I'll put that link in the information also, David.
Okay.
That way, you guys can link up with SuperMEX, the fan page, and just kind of see where the film's at, what's going on with the film. David, you're always kind of updating that on a regular basis with any updates that you might have on the production and where things are at, correct?
I'm trying to. I mean, I'm not very computer savvy. I mean, my first computer was an Etch-a-Sketch. So, trying to work it.
All right, guys. We will now sign off. Thank you so much. And remember to always go after your dreams, no matter what anybody says. Just run out and do it. David, I think this was addressing your comment earlier. Just run out and do it. Just do it because this guy does it. I do it. So just run out and make your dreams happen. We will close out with the SuperMEX trailer one last time. And then we'll kind of kill it after that. Thanks a lot for tuning in, David.
Yeah. And enjoy it. Again, I mean, thank you, Edgar, for allowing me to come on and being the guest tonight. This is exciting. Again, I'm enjoying the ride. And good luck, best of luck to all my film producer colleagues out there and anybody just trying to get into the business. Make it happen. Get it done.
That's true. David, sorry, comment right there. Thanks to David, the writer and the director, for sharing your vision. Yes, David, thank you. And that's awesome. That's always awesome. I know the feeling. But David, this is definitely your moment with regards to it being your project. That's an awesome feeling when you know that that somebody took something away from your vision because you shared it.
Yeah, and just seeing how everything has come together, the friendships that I've made, the folks that I've met along the way, the guidance that I've had, the regañadas that I've had, and all been a learning experience. So it's been great.
And David, hook up with David, with Dave Membrila, on right here on Facebook, man. Just go into my friends. He's right there. SuperMEX page. Just link up with Dave, okay? You guys, thank you very much. Talk to you guys later. David Gonzalez, thank you for, and everybody, thank you for all your comments. And to close out the SuperMEX trailer one last time, I'm writer-director Edgar Ibarra. This has been Filmspiration. Thanks a lot.
Hello, everybody, and thanks for checking out the trailer to the movie SuperMEX. Stick around for a brief message afterwards on how you, too, can become a part of our dream team to get our vision up on the big screen. Thanks and enjoy.
Mr. Yeyo.
I don't remember much.
El Yeyo, cabrón.
What are you talking about?
Mr. Yeyo.
You have the wrong house.
Don't
hagas
pendejo.
You have the wrong house.
Play
stupid with me, man.
I heard the sound of an AK.
And then, in an instant, everything changes. My family, my life, everything. Gone. Then, homeless. But the people on the street took me in. And the community embraced me.
This is it right here.
Mrs. Sanchez, open the door!
Lito's probation officer says he hasn't been seen in some time. Doesn't call in, check in, hasn't shown up for work.
I know. I haven't seen him either.
It's more than that, senora. Coach cut him some slack because of the deal we made. If we gotta come back, he ain't gonna be.
Easy. You entiendo?
I hope you do.
I understand.
I hope you do. Here we go again.
I had to give back somehow. But it wasn't enough. So I had to get tough by getting my ass kicked. To find my family's killers. And teach helpless Ready? Victims yes. to defend themselves.
Elbows in.
Go. Good. Snap it back.
Hit. Left, right.
You got me there.
So I'm walking past this restaurant called Michas.
Something like that.
This guy just stops me.
Hey, man, this guy stinks. My God. Hey, your food's in the back, man. Go to the garbage dump.
Hey, I'm just trying to order my food.
You know what? I'm gonna put a stop to this.
Hold on. Let's see what happens.
Hey, I'm just
you know,
trying to get my food.
Come on.
Hey, dude, this stuff really works.
But I made some friends along the way.
So, how'd you get all the way to Tucson?
Again, I don't remember much. I left El Paso.
Hey, SuperMEX. Heard about your vigilante escapades.
Yeah, she can't keep a secret.
and got a little unwanted attention.
We finally discovered why the homeless have been able to defend themselves when accosted on the street. It seems that they've been getting trained by this man, Arturo Mendez. Yes, folks, there is a new sheriff in town, or at least a new marshal. Martial art, as he's being called by our station. Mr. Mendez, would you give us a few words for our station? We want to know how you've been training the homeless. We have a lot of questions. We want to know, do you know Jackie Chan? Who has trained you? What is the motivating force behind the work you're doing? Why are you running from me? We finally discovered why the homeless have been able to defend themselves on the street. It seems that they've been getting trained by this man, Arturo Mendez. Yes, folks, there is a new sheriff in town, or at least a new marshal. Martial art, as he's being called by our station. Mr.
Antonio, we got a problem.
Do you know Jackie Chan?
What is, you're working on another case outside of our jurisdiction, Santana? What gives?
Nothing really. Most investigations taking place after hours.
So we're working on other people's crimes with taxpayers' dimes? Just what we need to hit the newspapers. Stops now. Got it?
Sir, we believe there's a connection in trafficking between El Paso and Tucson.
Wow! And you figure there's a connection between two border towns? What's next?
You're gonna tell me they're smuggling drugs into the country.
But sir, we...
Shh! You're here as a favor, and a favor only. Today. Stops. Today.
I promise you we're not gonna waste taxpayers'
money. Stops today!
Our target subject is Omar Sosa. He's the brother of Antonio Sosa, both of El Paso. Both have done time for trafficking. We need to figure out what kind of motive Omar would have for double-crossing Antonio, assuming, of course, that he thought Antonio's house was yours. So we have to surveil like crazy.
But like I said, I had friends.
Monitor everything and everybody who comes in, who comes out. Take mental notes. Write down license plate numbers. Anything and everybody. Got it?
Which is a good thing, because I also had enemies.
I'm Eagle.
I'm
out of violence, man. I abhorred violence.
Look at your friend. He messed up my wall.
Tell me what I need to know.
And I pray they don't find me.
Where is this guy? Mendez.
Before I find them.
Welcome back, and we hope you enjoyed the trailer to the movie SuperMEX. But that's just what it is. Right now, it's just a trailer. The movie that has not been produced yet, this is where we need your help. Please join us in donating to our crowdfunding efforts and helping us realize the vision of getting SuperMEX. Welcome back. We hope you enjoyed the trailer screen and in theaters across the country. That's just what it is. No donation is too big or too small. The movie, please share it with your friends on Facebook. This is where you're a fan of independent film. Please like your song and donate to our crowdfunding efforts. And any donation will help. Welcome back. Thanks a lot. Enjoy the big screen and in theaters across the country. Just what it is. No donation is too big or too small.